Hello and welcome to MedQuick. I am Dr. Vipul Rawlani and I have done my MBBS from GMC Nagpur and I will present you with short videos of 5 to 6 minutes covering important topics for NEET PG exam. So let us start. So let us begin with our approach to a case of renal disorder in our exam. So the damage to the kidneys can occur by three mechanisms. First one is damage caused due to decrease in blood supply to the kidneys, which comes under pre-renal cause. Second is damage caused directly to kidney due to infections or nephrotoxins. So it comes under renal cause. And third one is damage caused due to obstruction in the urine outflow tract, like stones or stricture. So it comes under post-renal cause. In our exams, we can differentiate pre-renal and renal cause from post-renal cause just by looking into pain. If pain is present, it is post-renal. And if pain is absent, it is renal or pre-renal. So if there is a patient who comes with painless hematuria, so the cause will not be post-renal, it will be pre-renal or renal. But if patient comes with a case of painful hematuria, the cause will be post-renal. Okay, so main difficulty in our exams comes between pre-renal and renal causes. So to differentiate these, let us first understand the mechanism. In pre-renal, there will be decrease in blood supply to the kidneys. So kidney try to retain more salt and water and urea. So ultimately, urine sodium decreases, blood urea increases, and urine concentration is high, and patient excretes very highly concentrated urine. So we can summarize in this table, like urine osmolarity is high, urine sodium and fractional excretion of sodium is low, burn by serum creatinine ratio is high. Whereas in comparison to the renal cause, there is direct damage to the tubules. So kidneys cannot reabsorb salt and water and urea. So there is salt and water wasting. So patient excretes very dilute urine. So we can tabulate this in this manner, like urine osmolarity is low as patient cannot concentrate the urine. As there is salt and water wasting, urine sodium and fractional excretion of sodium is increased, and also the urea is wasted in the urine, so burn by serum creatinine ratio is reduced. Also in renal cause, there is tubular necrosis, so necrotic cells appear in the urine as muddy brown or granular cast. So let us summarize this in one table. Like in pre-renal azotemia, urine osmolarity will be more than 500. Urine sodium will be reduced to less than 20, fractional excretion of sodium will be reduced less than 1%, and serum burn by creatinine ratio will be more than equal to 20, and the exactly opposite occurs in renal failure. And as we already know, in post-renal azotemia, there will be pain and oliguria. So let us now jump into causes of each. So pre-renal causes are hypovolemia, congestive heart failure, liver failure, renal artery stenosis, and NSAIDs. So NSAIDs basically inhibit the prostaglandin synthesis. So efferent arterioles are unable to dilate, resulting in decreased blood supply and pre-renal failure. So renal causes can be related to glomerulus like acute glomerulonephritis, tubular and interstitium like acute tubular necrosis. Acute tubular necrosis, which occurs due to ischemia or nephrotoxins. Nephrotoxins can be contrast cisplatin, aminoglycoside, hemoglobin, myoglobin, and third is interstitium. So interstitial causes can be acute interstitial nephritis. Acute interstitial nephritis, it is an example of hypersensitivity reaction. So patient will present with hypersensitivity like symptoms like rash, fever, pyuria. So in pyuria, there will be increased eosinophil count. So if patient presents like this, it is mostly acute interstitial nephritis. Causes of acute interstitial nephritis can be 5 P's. First P is P, like diuretic. Second is P. Second P comes with pain-free, like NSAID. Third P is penicillin. Fourth P is rifampin. Fifth P is sulfadrug. So, and third one is post-renal cause, like stones and cleanser. So now let us jump into questions. So let us read our first question. Patient present with nausea, fatigue, oliguria for past 3 days. Investigation reveal urine osmolarity 800, urine sodium 10, burn by serum creatinine. So what is the most likely diagnosis? So as we can see, urine osmolarity is increased, urine sodium is less, burn by serum creatinine ratio is increased. So the cause is pre-renal. So the answer is 1. Let us suppose that we do not know anything about this option, about this question. We do not know anything. We have not read anything. Still, we can come to a conclusion like, we can exclude post-renal as patient does not have pain. So pain is not given, means post-renal is not there. Okay. एंड सेकेंडली एक्यूट कॉर्टिकल नेक्रोसिस एंड रीनल कॉजेज बोथ आर सेम कैटेगरी सो वी कैन रोल आउट दीज बोथ ऑप्शन सो अल्टीमेटली वी कैन ऑल्सो कम इन टू कंक्लूजन बाय एलिमिनेशन दैट द आंसर इज वन ओके सो लेट अस जंप इन टू सेकेंड क्वेश्चन कॉजेज ऑफ नॉन ऑलिगोलिक रीनल फेलियर मे बी सीन नॉन ऑलिगोलिक यूरिक रीनल फेलियर मे बी सीन इन विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंडीशन सो इट इज मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन सो लेट अस लुक इन टू ऑल द ऑप्शंस First one is congestive heart failure. In congestive heart failure, there is reduced blood supply. So urine production will be low. So reduced urine production. So it will be an example of oligouric renal failure. Okay, not non-oligouric renal failure. Second is contrast-induced nephropathy. Third is aminoglycoside. Both are nephrotoxins. So in both of these, tubules will be damaged directly. So there is direct tubular damage. So patient will not be able to excrete concentrated urine. So patient will present with polyuria. So both of these will come under non-oliguric renal failure. Fourth one is RPGN. In RPGN, there is direct, RPGN stands for rapidly progressive glomerular nephritis. So there is direct damage to glomerulus. So this thing is directly damaged. So urine formation cannot occur. As a result of which patient excretes less urine. So there will be oliguria. So it will be an example of oliguric renal failure. And fifth one is acute interstitial nephritis. In acute interstitial nephritis, interstitium is hampered, interstitium is damaged. So patient will not be able to excrete concentrated urine. So there will be more amount of urine. So it will present to non-oliguric renal failure. So thank you very much.